Now, if you heard it once, you've probably heard it 100 times. Audio is one of the most important things when it comes to your video, and it sure is nice to have some music playing in the background while you're talking to the camera or you're doing a voiceover. But what's not nice about that is to manually adjust the loudness of your music track using keyframes, and this is where automatic audio ducking comes in clutch. So basically what I have right here is my voiceover on audio track number 1 and my music on audio track number 2. Let's have a listen and see if you can tell what I'm saying. Number 5. Morph. Drag the smooth cut transition in between two very similar. It's very hard to tell what I'm saying, right? So what you're gonna do now is click on this music track and lower the volume to around -7. Then what we wanna do is go to the Fairlight page, and now you see I have my music track right there and my voiceover right there. Let's have a listen to see what it sounds like when I lower the volume and see if you can tell what I'm saying. Number 5. Morph. Drag the smooth cut transition in between two very similar clips and adjust the length to your liking. It got a little bit better, but not too much. So the technique that I'm about to show you is crazy simple and will save you so much time down the road. So let's first go to the mixer, audio track number 1, double click on dynamics. So we got this dynamics window coming up, and then we want to activate the compressor. And now, because we don't want to compress the voiceover as of right now, we have to turn our threshold all the way down. Once we've done that, we see this sidechain. Now what you want to do is click on send. So let's close this window, go to audio track number 2, double click in dynamics, and audio track number 2 is our music, so we activate the compressor and activate listen. And basically what this does is whenever my voice kicks in, Resolve automatically lowers the volume of the music, which is a great feature, but it doesn't work that great with the default settings. So we have to change a little bit on attack, hold, and release. First of all, attack is how fast or how slow Resolve detects that your voice kicks in, and how fast or slow it will lower the volume of the music track. So hold basically is whenever you're doing a pause in speaking, Resolve will hold the volume of the music track down for as long as you determine. If you set this to 0, if you're doing just a minor speak pause, Resolve will bump up the volume of the audio just right after you stopped speaking. Now release basically is how fast or how slow Resolve detects that you stopped speaking, and then increase the volume of the audio. Now what I found is if I increase the attack to around 50, or 60, the hold should be, for my likings, I do a lot of speaking pauses, so I set this to around 2300, and the release should be on 300 or something like that. Again, this depends on how you're talking. Now we can set the threshold on how much Resolve should compress the audio, something like -20, and the ratio just a little bit up. Perfect. And now if we X out of this and have a listen on what this sounds, you will be impressed. Number 5. Morph. Drag the smooth cut transition in between two very similar clips and adjust the length to your liking. You see the release now, there was a little bit long because I stopped speaking and it just bumped up the audio somewhere right there. So I can lower my release. But in general, if I were to do something like this and have a listen now. Number 5. Morph. Drag the smooth cut transition in between two very similar clips. Number 5. Morph. Drag the smooth cut transition in between two very similar clips and adjust the length to your liking. This is so much more easy than manually going into your music track and setting keyframes to where you want the audio to be quieter and then adjust it that way. This is so much more time consuming.
So that's about wraps it up, guys. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If so, please consider leaving a like and a subscribe if you haven't already to not miss out on any upcoming content in the future, but also to help me spread out this video to even more people that might be interested in that specific topic. So with that being said, guys, hope you all have a nice New Year's Eve. See you in 2022. Until then, bye.